Man's search for the fountain of youth and the source of beauty has been going on since time immemorial. We may not be hiking forests now, but today's society is still at it with all the preoccupation about stem cell treatments, makeup, clothes, and every possible treatment to look good. So today, we look at the cost of finding the right look and how it can impact on our finances. I'm Edric Mendoza, and this is On The Money. Joining us today is Ms. Abigail Arenas De Leon, a professional image consultant and a former beauty queen title holder. Hi, Abby.
Ganun ba yun?
Yeah, that's right. Great wave.
Hi,
welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's good to be here. My first time.
Yeah, so we're excited to hear your perspective on the cost of beauty. Are you ready to talk about that?
Okay. Yes, but you'll be surprised that I'm not very much, magastos.
Which is good.
When it comes to beauty, believe
good.
It or not. I'm not.
That's probably why you're here then.
Probably,
you're the perfect person to talk to about
probably.
This. So yeah, so let's start off. Tell me, people think you need to have a lot of money to look good. I mean, just from what you said earlier, maybe it's not all that.
Talking to a friend a while ago, parang sabi ko, okay, you always have to stay happy so that you'll be beautiful. How do you keep that happy mood? Sabi ko, well, of course, you have to have a happy home and a happy work life. Kanyan sabi niya, so walang bayad. Sabi ko, meron. Hindi rin happy ang home pagka marami kang bills na kailangan bayaran. Hindi happy ang home pag the relationship is not so good.
Makes sense.
Hindi happy ang work kapag ang mga tao mo hindi magagaling, so dapat magagaling na tao. So it's not cheap to have that happy home and happy work life.
It takes effort. So let's say for people that aren't a beauty queen, right? For people who have to actually make an effort and they're trying to get the whole package, you're saying, no, parang good house, etc., good relationship. But they have to go to work, they have to look good for their bosses, and they want to do something decent.
That's exactly what I do.
Perfect.
I am an image consultant. What we do, what I do at Personify is we give lectures and trainings to employees. Mm-hmm. Now, ang approach natin is A, B, and C. It will always be. So when we talk about the professional image, let's say, the clients would call me, okay, Abby, gusto namin i-professionalize yung aming company
workforce, or the
workforce. And then we'd like to make sure that the branding would go together with its people. And then I'm going to come in. Okay. Now, when we talk about professional image, you just don't give them lipstick and eyeliner and boom.
I hope
of course.
Okay.
So it's going to take A, B, C. There's appearance, behavior, and communication. Now, of course, appearance, it's going to be that uniform. It's going to be the shoes, the standard, the length, the fitting, lahat yun. And then the behavior would be on how people will be, the etiquette, the culture of the company.
Right. Can you do that for just one person?
Yes, we do that for one person.
Maybe you have tips and tricks that, people can learn from. Yeah.
First and foremost, if you want to look good, you have, let's say, okay na yung mindset mo, okay na lahat. You have to stand up straight. You have to have a good posture.
Posture.
Because even how expensive clothes, even with expensive clothes,
if you don't stand right, exactly.
Diba? Now, you have to have
a straight body.
Straight body.
Watch my posture, right? Okay. Good advice.
Yan ang nangyayari. Every time I'm in front of people, parang, ay, nakukonsyos
ako. Watch your posture.
Aside from the posture, you have to have a good smile.
People think, What is a good smile?
Now, I have a very famous program wherein I teach people how to smile properly.
Really?
There are actually three steps. I'm
going
to share that to you.
Three steps.
Three tips on how to make a good, how to smile properly.
Right.
First, it starts with a happy thought.
Okay.
I mean, if you try to think, bad things and stuff like that, the smile will really come out,
contorted,
bad, horror. Yeah.
Sure.
So, happy thoughts.
Happy thoughts.
Number two, you need to show the lines around the eyes.
Some women would say,
ay, walang lines. But then again, if you don't show the lines on your eyes, ang pangit ng smile mo.
Right.
So you show the
it's
lines.
Natural.
It has to look natural.
Okay.
And then finally, you have to make a curve sa bibig.
Curve.
And how do you do the curve?
Yeah.
You try to say the letter A.
A.
A. That curves it. When you say cheese, that ruins it. Makeup.
A lot of our viewers might want tips and tricks with makeup.
Makeup. Women would normally think, ay, ang mahal. Right. Ay, ang tagal. Yeah. Ay, ang hindi ako marunong. Yes. You know, ay, allergic ako. But in reality, to have a developed image or to, you know, just to look good, blush on can help. Mm-hmm. A little bit of eyebrows can help. A little bit of lipstick can help. Mm-hmm. In reality, it's not expensive to buy makeup. Mm-hmm. It becomes expensive when you buy the wrong kind.
Interesting.
Let's say, for example, you the sales lady got you into buying that green eyeliner. I mean, if you are a banker, how many times will you ever wear that green eyeliner,
di ba? Yeah, so, I can imagine.
So
yeah.
You, let's say, okay, sige, may gimmick, may party, 2-3 times. Ibig sabihin nun, if you bought that for 500
Sayang
pesos,
lang, I understand.
200 per application.
250 bawat, ano?
Per application, di ba? But if you buy the right type, the right color, let's say, okay, may brown eyeliner ka, and then you get to wear that every single day, hanggang sa lumiit ng gusto, you maximize, then makeup becomes cheap. Makeup becomes affordable.
I see that you have a couple of kits there that might be able to help expound.
During the interview. during the interview.
Saving for makeup.
Kasi, well, part of the program that I show is makeup is affordable.
Okay.
So I have to come up with a set of products wherein patutunayan ko sa kanila that
it
makeup
is affordable.
Is affordable.
Sure.
So I can
prove it.
Diba? Prove
it. Good, yeah.
So I have this product here that's about 400, 500 pesos total.
Only for the whole kit.
Only for the whole kit. That will include brushes, the sponge, the lip gloss. I mean, they might not be top quality, but they do work.
So that's 400. What's in there,
What's in here would be a set of brushes, about 5 pieces of brushes, and that's all you need. I mean, if you want to, you look polished lang. And then a blush. Well, normally there are 4 steps. Hala, i-lecturean kita sa makeup.
Go. I mean, this is for our viewers, right?
Okay. There are 4 steps. If you are an employee and would have about 10 minutes to fix yourself in the morning, I would say touch on your face, touch on your eyes, touch on your cheeks and your lips, and you're set to go.
Good.
So 400, 500 pesos for a startup kit, that will do. And you know what I do? I do a demonstration just using this.
Really? That 400 peso kit?
That 400 peso kit. Anybody among the participants.
Anybody from the crew? Oh, no, it's okay. No live demos here.
So
okay,
I go like that, and then I'll do it for less than 10 minutes. And then, you see, that's all I used. And then normally what I do is, okay, you go try. You know, you go try. And I have products.
I see.
Tapos, I give them a leeway na mga 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. Tapos after that, parang, hi, we all look good. We all look good.
And they didn't have to spend as much money.
It costs so little.
Galing.
But of course, meron din tayong mga, some clients would prefer to have, you know, kasi startup kit, mga made in China yan.
Right.
And then I have the mga made in Japan, made in US. So we also do that.
Okay.
So depending on the client. But
excellent.
But for me is, if you want to look good, it doesn't take a lot of money. It doesn't.
Tell me about investment dressing. You had a word.
Yes.
What is that? That sounds very curious.
Investment dressing is, well, first and foremost, before you have you go to that investment dressing, you need to have a lifestyle check.
Lifestyle check.
What is a lifestyle check? Let's say for you, what is your regular day like? Mm. So if you are going to be in the studio most of the weeks, so you are expected to be in your jacket, you know, in your dark suit, in your dark, you know, that's the look.
Okay.
I mean, if I see, and I would say, kunwari lang, you work 5 times a week in a studio, dressed up like this. And then every weekend, you go diving, kunwari.
Sure.
You go diving, you go.
So different dress altogether.
Different altogether. You will have to check on the lifestyle, your current lifestyle. So, Monday to Friday, you are dressed in a corporate upscale.
Okay.
So, medyo corporate attire, medyo upscale or low scale, pwede yan. And then, diving.
Yeah.
So, if I look at your wardrobe and I'd see a lot of big rubber shoes there for basketball For basketball, I'd go,
mali
yata yan, di ba? So what I do to my clients is I make them list down their week like.
A typical week.
A typical week. And then
very
they write
good.
It down. And then I ask them to close their eyes. Okay, now compare that in percentage
to what you have in your wardrobe. I see.
And then some would go, magkaiba.
Right.
I mean, if I ask you now, how many high heels do you have?
Yes.
She'd go, one pair. How many days a week do you need to wear those heels?
Five days. I see.
Tapos, how many chinelas do you have? You got 10.
So very, I understand. Very good.
So you have to have that lifestyle check mo now. First of all, you see to it that you shop according to your current lifestyle. And then you do investment dressing.
I understand.
Once you know your lifestyle, and then let's say, for example, okay, so normally, suit skirt, okay, or suit pants, okay. So, tignan mo ngayon, so how many do you have? So, if you need black, you know, of course, basic yan eh, black, navy blue, brown, basic yan eh. then buy the best quality. I mean, if you're the type of person na yo-yo ang weight,
right,
then don't
you
get
something,
you
obviously,
want you
yeah.
want to have something that you know you can you can get rid
okay.
in a while. So
sure.
investment dressing will come in cheaper because if a pair of pants you get to use at 5 years,
you maximize it.
You get to wear it once a week.
I never, even for guys, this makes sense, huh?
It does.
It makes sense. It's not just for women. Okay, wow.
It's for everybody. It's very practical.
Right. Do people, so in looking at investment dressing, I think brands also factor in there. Some people buy brands na di naman pala nila afford. I mean, you want to talk about that?
Some people will buy brands na ang mahal-mahal pero hindi sukat sa kanilang lifestyle.
Diba? Important din yan.
Oo,
okay.
Baka mamaya, bibili nga ng pagkamahal-mahal, biglang mm-hmm. nagta-tricycle pala. Uh-huh. Hello, di ba? E di nagbukang fake yung suot niya.
Yeah, that's important.
It is very important.
Okay.
It has to match your lifestyle.
Yeah.
It has to match your means as well.
Right, excellent. You know, Abby, we're going to have more questions for you.
Okay.
Very, very lively and interesting discussions, but we have to pause for a short break right now, so keep it here on The Money. We'll be right back. Time now for a daily dose of Salvices with Salvi Duplito.
Early this month, we talked about a new Ponzi scam that victimized investors in Pagadian City. Securities and Exchange Commissioner Juanita Cueto said in an interview that at least 200 million pesos has been invested in this scam. Just like in previous Ponzi operations, investors were blinded by the 30% guaranteed return that the Ponzi operators were giving every 8 days.
Well, from the report that we asked, the basis of our CDO was something like 200 plus million. Well, at least we were able to contain it to Pagadian. Take note that there weren't really a lot of any complainants yet. I mean, there were reports that people were queuing as early as 3 a.m. just to make placements. Well, we've given them time to do their comments, but there is the cease and desist order. Apparently, they were pooling funds. They were collecting funds, promising ginormous rates.
The government has issued a cease and desist order on the company owned by a Filipino with ties in Malaysia.
We are getting in touch with the Malaysian government whether the funds that they purport to sell are really funds and legit in Malaysia. So we're all verifying this.
A Ponzi scam is one of the oldest cons in the financial world. It uses the siren call of guaranteed high returns to entice clueless investors. But who doesn't want guaranteed high returns? The problem with this is fraudsters merely use the money of new investors to pay off the old ones. Ponzi scams always fall, but Filipinos seem to have very short memories and get into these get-rich-quick schemes every 3 or 4 years.
Actually, this is where we've agreed with our chair that I think we should remind the public more often. It's also cyclical as the market, you know, there are ebbs and tides and then crests and downs. I see also a pattern with these scams. I mean, they're cyclical. First you have all these multi-trillion, then they're quiet. And then suddenly in some remote area of the country, it emerges again, a new scam emerges again. And I think the public should be reminded more often.
With these scams, you're just chasing rainbows. So do three things. Stay informed, guard your money, and invest in legitimate and transparent instruments.
Time and time again, we've always reminded the public, if there is an offer, our doors are open, we are open, we have information. They can always ask whether this product is registered with us, whether this is a legit product, or whether even the salesman is licensed to solicit and sell these products to them. We have a list of licensed salesmen, and we have a list of licensed securities that we have studied and registered for public investment.
Still with us is Ms. Abigail Arenas De Leon, professional image consultant and a former beauty queen title holder. She will answer some of the money questions you sent us via email, Twitter, and Facebook. Hi, Mel.
Hi, Edric. Mm-hmm. Hello, Abigail.
Hello, Melissa.
Ay.
Ay.
Yes, that's a good one, right?
Ay. But I love cheese. Sorry.
Eat cheese, say ay. I mean, that's a good way to kind of remedy it, right?
Yeah.
No, it's not bad to eat cheese. But
that's true. Okay, yeah. Sorry. So, yeah. First question from social media. This comes from Mary via Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
And she says, a tenth of my budget is for salon expenses. I want to reduce that, but I don't know how to let go of my every other day shampoo and blow dry sessions and hair treatments. My hair needs them. I also spend on my weekly mani-pedi. Wow, that's pricey.
That's pricey.
That is pricey. Yeah.
A tenth of the budget, that's a lot.
That's
if you go every the other day on a known beauty salon, it's going to cost a lot. Well, number one, either you can discover small salons wherein they would charge like the tiny price of the cheaper price. So either discover a more low-end salon, or you can go do it yourself.
Yes.
Learn to do it yourself. There are a lot of classes, a lot of schools nowadays that offers, you know,
tutorials on how to do
your own.
Yeah.
And you can save a lot. I mean,
definitely.
I do my hair and makeup every day. Imagine if I need to pay for that. I'm just.
I totally agree. Why should you pay someone to do something that's on your head?
Especially
all the time.
If she does it like every the other day, you can just learn it, or have a yaya attend the training.
That's true.
Or the seminars.
Yes.
There you go.
Actually, that's
kind of
really
solution,
good.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like
and
even
I know
for
a lot
waxing,
of do
you
that.
Get your yaya to
right.
learn
exactly.
how to do it.
So you, a little investment in the beginning. I mean, maybe a lot in the beginning, but after that, it's just you can just have it every day.
Exactly. That's so true.
Puede. Yes.
Okay. Good. So now we. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Okay, Mary, good.
Okay, yes. So next question, Francis. I've checked out teeth whitening procedures. The cheapest I've found in our area is $15,000. Are there less expensive alternatives? Yeah, are there?
Yes, there are. Well, the ones in the store that you get from the store,
okay.
they have that. I mean, I've tried several actually. That works.
Okay.
I don't know if they have it here, so probably you can get it in the States. But it's less than $15,000. But I also did whitening professionally. It's really, really well. But there's a big difference.
Right.
But it's really, really good. But
good.
If you are working on a budget, I would say try mo muna yung mas mura.
Okay. Now we have Joanne who asks. I have a friend who has tried various diet plans to lose weight. Now she has to do the Cohen diet. She has to. I already told her that she has to be financially prepared for that because the consultation and the actual program entails costs. I don't think she has that amount of money for now. What other weight loss options can she try?
Huh. As I mentioned kanina, well, share your food to a friend,
right? Yeah, exactly.
Cut your intake. Or, well, there are people who would actually need extra help just to motivate and stuff like that. So, yes, you can go on a Cohen diet if your budget will allow you. Mm-hmm. But since we're all green here, we're talking about money. And the next one is go to the gym, hit the gym, exercise. Because even if you cut the food out, you know, you the muscles exercise. Would need toning.
Yes.
So, now, if you have the money, why don't you get a personal trainer to do that and then tell him which specific part that you'd like trimming? So maybe we can do something about
that. Yeah, I think the personal trainer is better. And plus, when you lose weight, you lose muscle mass first.
Exactly.
You don't lose your fat.
Exactly.
You know, so, and maybe instead of paying for a Cohen diet, she can just cut back on her food.
No groceries for 2 months.
Food.
Yeah, and some
eat
simple exercise
food.
That won't even entail
or
gyms. Running.
Yeah.
Just, you know. Cardio,
or
cost
eat
much?
the usual food that, you know, let's say kamote, saging na saba, di ba? Parang this does not cost money, but then again, they make you lose weight. That's the problem with what we have now, di ba?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, now Sheena asks, she says, you always remind your viewers to come up with a list of expenses, and I did just that. I found out that I'm spending quite a lot on makeup. Even if I've not used up my lipstick or eyeshadow, I just buy and buy whenever I see a color I like. I also prefer the expensive brands, so that's not helping my finances at all. What can I do?
I would say go back to the basics. Well, that's the beauty of being a woman, you know, you can just buy all the colors and finally you see it in the bank account. But the thing is, be practical and wag papadala sa commercial.
Exactly.
Yeah, and you can collect and then you can probably swap colors with your friends. Mm-hmm. You know, if you want to try a color, then your friend would have swap colors.
That's
Because a colored eyeshadow palette, makikita mo, you will hardly use that.
Yeah, that's right. You only need the one color.
You only need one or two colors. I mean, I would say browns and golds would suit a working woman anytime. So if you have the purple and the green and the silver there, so swap lang. So makeup party, swap.
Maximizing talaga. It's what works.
Yeah, you don't need the brands. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Anyway, send us your money questions via email or through Facebook and Twitter, and we'll try to answer them in our upcoming episodes or on our next Q&A Friday.
Beauty is not just in the outward, as you were saying.
Exactly.
Like it's a lifestyle, you know.
Yeah.
Appearance, behavior, communication. Excellent. Great discussion, ladies. Thank you again. That's our show today. I'm Edric Mendoza. Join us again tomorrow for more talk and tips so you're always right on the money.